Four treasures of the study.
笔, 墨, 纸,
印, inkbrush, ink, paper, and inkstone. Today, let's have a look at the Chinese four treasures of the study.
笔, 墨, 纸,
印, namely, inkbrush, ink, paper, and inkstone. Among the four treasures of the study, the inkbrush is regarded as the treasure among treasures. The oracle bones excavated from the archaeological site of Yin ruins show that the prototype of writing pens appeared as early as the Xia and Shang dynasties. In the Warring States period, people started to make and use bamboo pens. In 223 BC, General Meng Qian from the state of Qin was leading an army fighting an intense war against the state of Chu. Meng Qian would regularly write and report the latest development of the war regularly to the king of Qin. However, as the bamboo pen was very hard, dipping it in too much ink had easily soiled the expensive silk on which to write the letter. One day, when he was hunting, he came up with an inspiring idea. Voila! Why not attach some rabbit hair to the bamboo pen to make it softer? However, the rabbit hair, unprocessed and untreated, could not effectively absorb the ink, making it all but impossible to write consistently. Frustrated by the result, Meng tossed his pen into a stone pit in front of his door. A few days later, Meng happened to see the pen he threw away. He picked it up, hoping against hope that the second time's a charm. It turned out that the water in the pit was calcareous, and its alkalinity neutralized and helped remove the fat and grease of the rabbit hair, which had made it soft and ink-absorbing. There are various types of ink brushes. In terms of the hairs used, you can find wool and wolf hair. In terms of hardness, you can find hard ones, soft ones, and those in between. In terms of the materials used for the body, you will find bamboo, ivory, and tortoiseshell. Ink was created roughly at the same time as ink brushes. In the early stages, only natural ink was used. During the reign of the Emperor Shuang of the Zhou Dynasty, people started to use artificial ink, which took pine soot or plain tree soot as the raw material, and was produced after strict matching and molding. From Wei, Jin, the Northern and Southern Dynasties, to the Tang, Song, and Ming Dynasties, the ink-making craft had been steadily improved, and different ink-making schools had gradually appeared since then. During the Qing Dynasty, apart from practical use, ink became an artwork with collectible value as well. Interestingly, ancient pine soot ink was actually edible. In his compendium of Materia Medica, Li Shizhen wrote the harmless nature of the pine soot ink. In fact, apart from the fragrant ink, the common writing ink, there is the medical ink, which is believed to have a detoxing effect. As for eating ink, there are famous works by Chinese poets and scholars. Examples include Su Shi's well-known lines, a set of clothes worn over and over again. Those aspiring scholars can truly drink in ink. Huang Tianjian's, those arrogant boys from rich families, they can drink in three buckets of ink, and such everyday expressions. Drink ink, meaning to learn or to read, and not one bit of ink on one's chest, meaning unlearned or uncouth. Paper is an important medium for painting and calligraphy, and it's one of the four great inventions of China. The paper used for calligraphy and painting is called shuan paper or rice paper, and its raw materials are mostly composed of plant fibers. It is called shuan paper because it was originally produced in Xuancheng in Anhui province. According to the strength of its ink absorption, shuan paper can be categorized into shengshuan, untreated paper, or Xu Xuan, treated paper. The former has greater absorption of ink, while the latter less so. Inkstone is a tool for the Chinese people to grind and contain ink. In addition to stone, inkstones are also made from clay. The exquisite texture of stone-made inkstones is a symbol of the noble quality of Chinese literati, who are gentle but not flattering, rational but not indifferent. Indeed, only the right combination of ink and paper helps make great paintings and calligraphy. The inkstone is a tool for writing and painting. A good inkstone must be fast in issuing ink, must not destroy the ink brush, and must not drain the ink too quickly.